Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome back to Forest of Drizzling Rain. Previously on Forest of Drizzling Rain, we cut down a bunch of ghost babies, and we managed to save our main character. Ahsoka-kun? Yes? If we were to get out of this forest, what about your voice, Ahsoka-kun? Ahsoka-kun, your voice. Can't we get it back somehow? Don't worry about it. Now you started to sound like me. Your car is on fire. Don't worry about it. I think you're bleeding. Nah, don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. It's cool.
What is it? The protective charms. About that. Actually, while in the forest, one of them snapped each time I encountered something strange, so they've all broke. I'm sorry, even though you did so much handing them to me. That's what those protective charms are for.
Took her a while to put two and two together, huh?
Speaking of which, Ahsoka, that sword of yours, I get the feeling that it's slightly shining, but is that also made of night glow stone?
Yes, it's pretty obvious.
Did you make that, Ahsoka-kun? And could you have made that necklace too? Amazing, Ahsoka-kun. You've become as you said in the past.
Blushing internally. And externally.
Even the night glowstone has a limit. The sword is almost done. Let's hurry on ahead. Ahsoka-kun. Is it painful? Your throat. It's my fault. Quick. If we don't get out of here, Ahsoka-kun, you'll also...
This is one of the most appropriate moments to say you need to get alive. Heh. It's kind of funny.
Ahsoka-kun, are you alright?
Not really. Damn, you're annoying.
Ahsoka-kun? There was definitely an underground path that was connected to the well, in the lower path.
Oh? No bother. No bother. Ladder. Oh, still can't collect it. That means I gotta trigger the rope dialogue. Oh!
The water has risen due to the rain. We'll just swim. Ahsoka-kun, it's dark. It'd be reckless to swim further in.
Not really.
Let's look to see if there's another path. But this ladder is being held by a rope. If only we had a sharp object with us. Perhaps designed for cunning. Are you able to cut it with that sword?
Hmm.
You know, it's taken me all this time to realize I can walk at an angle. Holy crap. Look at this. Angle walk. Amazing. Put the ladder over here. Alright. Lock zone won't open. Why is it that there's so many doors underground like this? I don't know. Oh, this must lead right into the house, that means. In the distant past, our ancestors received the night glowstone from a certain man. Why is it that my ancestors agreed with that man's deeds? Perhaps they may have been deceived. It was because of that man, in order to entrap one woman he fell in love with, just for that purpose to deceive the people of the village. It was like mere lust. It was perhaps unmistakably a twisted love. That woman who was loved had her husband, child, and child in her belly killed, and was made to live her entire life in prison as a plaything. How could it be holy for us to pray to that stone implanted with love and hatred as a source of protection? I saw into the interior of its darkness. Just which generation among my ancestors would have made it like this in there? The filth was not in there. Rather, it was perhaps I who have done nothing who was the filthy one. Quite dreadful indeed. Almost everything was.
Well, there's your answer right there. The entire story is bullshit. It was all some fucked up thing that happened. And this ritual really sucks.
Why are they so tightly stuck together like that? In the interior of the forest of drizzling rain, is the haunt of a whirlpool of souls of love and hate. Who was the one who made it? However, the ones who deceived the village must have been none other than us. The Saint Mask is surely this. The disgusting deeds were in the inner forest, and so in this underground shrine.
Do it. Ooh, secret.
Secret.
Pure water. Masks. Come back to here in a second.
On the door above, a night glowstone is shining.
Ah.
The floor there is packed with some writing on it. A Buddhist sutra. What's it praying to? Could this be a casket? In order to save the woman, it is necessary to give offerings to the casket on a pedestal, with a purified corpse put inside. However,
The contents of the casket are incomplete, making it impossible to carry it out. Perhaps it is a sole hope that our ancestors, driven by guilty conscience, left behind. In order for the woman to not be completely consumed by the men-like demons who destroyed everything in insanity. As long as we don't find the missing part of the corpse, purify it, and restore it to its casket, the hope cannot sublimate. Even though it's just a tiny fragment. Fragment, hmm?
Let's see. Yep, this village sucks. Oh, crap. So pretty much the first flashback told it all. That this place was just hilariously evil, you would say. Just like no redemption whatsoever. So the demon itself, there must be a lot of ghosts and angry spirits out here now. But the main ghost is probably just a victim of the whole circumstance. Oni mask? Woman mask? Action mask? Some kind of puzzle here. By fragment, could it perhaps mean this? Maybe. Ah, so that was the item we found in the beginning of the game. Then, I'll put it in. It's probably the unborn child, that means, that was buried here. That kid right now, I know him. I met him in the forest when I was little. I see. This kid was always here, in order to meet his mother. Could this place be connected to the outside? Yes. Then, I'll need to do something to get out of here. But the ceiling is quite high. I'll need to call for help. There's no avail to worry over this. Let's try calling for help right now.
Okay.
They'll be alright, even if you don't worry. Because I have a big voice, and my throat is alright. Someone? Is someone there? Kapu-san! Stop eating donuts!
That's a stereotype.
If someone's there, please respond. Someone, kill.
This is really bad.
It'll be alright. Hey, we can't just give up here.
You're right, but I think this is still really bad.
Asuka-kun, you don't need to make such a tormented face. Because, Asuka-kun, until now you've always protected various people from that spirit, right? If so, then it'll be alright. Surely we'll be able to return safely today, too. It'll be alright. Because, Asuka-kun, when you were scared and cried, I also made a promise to protect you, Asuka-kun.
That touches my heart, but it's still, like, a really bad situation.
Alright. If it's decided like that, I'll need to raise a larger voice. The night closed down outside broke. But this voice is surely of a spirit like those children. Asuka-kun?
I gotta go and sacrifice myself for the good of the story.
You can't go that way. Even if it's not the Kotore Obake, the spirit of that child has come in. Eh?
Take this. Now I must sacrifice myself. Also, I love you.
This is a night glowstone. You want me to take it? The night glowstone is a protective charm, a purification stone. You can't. Hey, Asuka-kun, by giving this to me, what do you intend to do?
I'm going to probably sacrifice myself. It's really obvious.
This, you should have it, Asuka-kun.
You're really, really ruining my sacrifice here.
I can't accept it. I don't want to make Asuka-kun a victim of any more than this. This force is calling me. You don't need to become the victim, Asuka-kun. Hey, Asuka-kun. Why did you live for so many years in that museum, where there's nobody anymore? Why did you just simply try to chase me away once you knew who I was? Why did you, when I said I wanted to know about my dead parents, allow me to stay there?
This is a bad time.
Asuka-kun, you've always been trying to keep that promise, haven't you? It might not have been for my sake, but if it was, then... Please stop it. Let that promise be no more. Because I want to protect you, Asuka-kun.
Damn it. My heart.
So, Asuka-kun, take that stone with you.
Understood. I will take the stone with me. But, while I take the stone and go over to the other side, you will stay here. Because, I'll come back for sure.
Understood. And this time, I'll be calling for help, so just don't do something reckless. You must absolutely come back. Because it's a promise.
I know.
Asuka-kun? One-san, are you here? One-san, as I thought, you were here. Sakama-chan.
Hey, are you alright?
Officer Mochizuki, too. Oh, great. Please, help me out from here.
Understood. Just wait a little. Right now, I'll bring something you can climb. Good. With this, we can get out of here. But Asuka-kun is still... Asuka-kun! Oh, great, you are alright!
Things weren't too pretty out there.
You see, Sakuma-chan and Officer Mochizuki have noticed that we were in here.
Oh?
It's alright now. Asuka-kun?
I can for once smile in my life, despite what horrors I've seen.
One-san, we've brought it!
You guys, quickly get up from there.
And then, I was able to safely exit from that forest and that place underground. Sakuma-chan, who just saw me, cried out like a dog, and Officer Mochizuki made a bitter smile, as if feeling relieved. Perhaps because Sukakun also came to be relaxed a little, with an expression of blurred by fatigue, he also let out a laugh. And I suddenly cut the strung up string of tension, and only remember abruptly collapsing right there. Whatever the case, I think it was truly great we were able to get out of that forest. Sakuma-chan and Sukakun were alright. I was happy about that above all else.
The next day...
Suga-kun and Sakuma told me to very strongly go back.
The Kotore Obake is still looking for you, One-san.
Sakuma-chan, who said that with quite a serious face, had a terribly sad expression. But... I was a little hesitant to say anything. It was because there was something I was anxious about. Of course, it was about Suga-kun. For me, who remembered everything in the past, my promise with Suga-kun was quite precious. Concerning at least just him, there's no way I could make him the victim and let him suffer. I, thinking that, couldn't go back in honest good judgment. As I was like that, Asuka-kun smiled just a little, and softly wrote a memo for me.
Once the forest has calmed down, it'd be fine for you to come again. Because in that time, I'll contact you.
The words written in the pretty letters that he wrote looked sincere in all respects. To my question of really, he nodded several times, so I could only swallow those words. And so I decided to return at least once eventually. So now, I'll be returning back home. It's painful when I think of that, actually. It's tiresome only for you, Suga-kun, but...
Understood. Sakuma-chan also said that.
This is goodbye. But once it calms down, you'll absolutely contact me, alright? I have still not promptly made any thanks. I'm truly thankful, Suka-kun. I am glad I remembered that promise. Then, I'll be going now. Because it's just about the time the train will come. Suga-kun? Is that the night glowstone you had at the time, Suga-kun? Eh? Wait, Suga-kun? Hey, wait, Suga-kun? I don't wanna forget any...
And everything returned to status quo.
I hear the sound of a train. Faking this is strange, I opened my eyes. When I did so, I was surprised from the bottom of my heart that I was actually riding a train. This train I've never seen before, is merely running past places I've never seen before. How strange. I don't remember ever riding in such a train. Why am I riding in a train in the first place? I tried searching my memory, but I couldn't remember anything. In any case, I asked the ticket inspector around the conductor whether this train stops at the station at my home. Doing so, it seems that this train is running on a line far from the town where I live, and that I would need to change trains several times. More and more, I didn't know what was going on anymore, and my head puzzled over it. But in the end, I wasn't able to remember anything. In any case, I need to get back. Once I get back home, let's just sleep for now. Tomorrow, I'll need to visit my parents' grave. Even though I've been surely visiting a grave almost every day, I somehow got the feeling I haven't visited for a while. While thinking those wandering thoughts in order to escape from this unusual affair, I continued gazing at the flowering scenery until the station of my next switch. It's just as if something precious has gone completely missing. I get the feeling that it's something I definitely shouldn't have forgotten. Where have I ever ended up losing such a thing? Before I knew it, my cheeks had become wet with tears. You don't mind, right, Suka-kun?
Okay. Let's do this. Are you ready? So it's kind of funny, I did this whole event, but I forgot to take the fucking thing. Oh well.
For the pedestal, here it should be alright, right? Perhaps it's okay like this. That sound right now. Could it be the night glowstone outside just broke? Suka-kun?
We've been through this before, and I'm going to try to sacrifice myself once again.
Suka-kun, come back! Suka-kun?
Daijoubu.
Thank you.
They finally met, haven't they? The mother and the child. Let's go, at once. Surely the Kotore Obake is all right now. And we never have to say that name ever again.
Thank God. Oh, hold up. Now I just got to deal with all the ghost babies.
That's... no!
Oh, holy fucking Jesus Christ!
Tsuka-kun, the sword has... Tsuka-kun, it's too dangerous now.
My diamond sword.
It took me 2 hours to mine all that diamond. It disappeared.
It's over.
It's all right now. Surely, that child and mother can now properly be together from now on.
Yeah.
Hey, is anyone there? That voice, it's off from Mochizuki. Conveniently late. Let's go. We can get out of here now. Officer Mochizuki, I and Tsuga-kun are here. Onee-san? Sakuma-chan, so you're alright?
Hey, are you guys alright?
Officer Mochizuki, I'm alright. Please, help us out of here.
Understood. Just wait a little. Right now, I'll bring you something you can climb on.
Onee-san, what a relief, really. Sorry. I'm alright, so don't cry, okay? It's because Officer Mochizuki wouldn't listen to what I was saying that we've been slow to come to help. Since I was alright, and even though you said we'd be trying to save Onee-san first,
that's because you've been fainting all this time. I couldn't just let you wander around some more. I also might have ate some donuts.
Well, that's alright. It's thanks to that, we had everyone who was saved. However, what was that that happened in the forest? I can still hardly believe it at all. Furthermore, I would have never thought that the place was connected to this mansion. Anyways, for now, I'll write an appropriate report for this, so you should all arrange to tell the same story. Okay. Yeah. Alright. So, I'll be taking Sakuma back to her home. I'll also be taking my record book on a later day, so I'll call you guys then. Sakuma, let's go quickly. Your parents are deeply worried and are waiting for you. Quickly now, because I'll be apologizing together with you. I forgot to say this, Onee-san, but... like Forrest, it's alright now.
Eh?
Because there's no presence nor any voices. They have all been clearly purified. In fact, Onee-san, even if you come here or even live here, it'll be alright. Right? Suka-kun, after Mochizuki's investigation ends, I'll be going back home, right? From then on, about this mansion, Suka-kun, you should do what you want with it. After all, my memories of my parents have returned. As Hakama-chan said, the forest has been purified, and that promise with the Kotore Obake is no more. And so, Suka-kun, there's no need for you to be bound here anymore. Sorry for causing you so much trouble. We weren't able to get back your voice, Suka-kun, but... thank you. With this, I fulfilled my promise with you, Suka-kun, haven't I? For now, let's rest for today. From tomorrow, I'll need to do something about my inheritance paperwork, and also need to make preparations for going back. Wait. Suka-kun? She-chan? Asuka-kun, your voice! What is it, Asuka-kun? What? Despite having my voice back, I'm still gonna be a mute. Just because I'm so embarrassed now. I must write my feelings in a memo. Because it's just too embarrassing. Again, memo. Moe. There's a lot I'd like to talk about. Yeah. Me too. There's a lot I'd like to talk about too, Suka-kun.
Thank you.
So that's it for Forest of Drizzling Rain. This is a game I have real mixed feelings about. It's held back a little bit by the translation errors, but mainly the pacing. At times I actually like this game, and other times I'm kind of about it. I wouldn't put it on the same level as Ebe or any of those, but I could say that its writing is definitely competent enough, where I pretty much knew what was going on. It revealed everything and didn't keep anything hidden or anything like that. It had some bad ends, had some good ends, everything's resolved. Not too scared of the game. It was more horror in a description sense of what actually happened, but the actual media threat was very small. So in the end, I'd rank this above a bunch of the games I've played that are RPG Maker horrors, but I wouldn't put it up there with the famous, kind of popular ones, just because of the kind of early pacing issues in this game. One more thing before I go. I want to mention there is a manga for this series. It's, I think, only one chapter right now, but its art seems pretty decent, and it kind of fits the character's age as described, while the in-game sprites and look kind of makes him look a lot older, so there's a little bit of consistency there. Anyway, so thank you all for watching me play Forest of Drizzling Rain. I'll see you guys later. Take it easy.